I'm Mark Wright. I'm a consultant hepatologist at Southampton General Hospital, and I've been looking after people with liver disease for about 10 years now. Liver disease is something that's increasing considerably in this country, and there's various reasons for that. You find out you've got alcoholic liver disease in particular. The most pertinent questions you should ask your doctor really are, at what stage is my liver at? There's lots of stages of alcoholic liver disease, ranging from end-stage liver disease to just some mild changes that are a warning, really. I'd ask my doctor what test he's going to be doing on me, and the likelihood is he'll start with a blood test, perhaps move on to an ultrasound scan, and then I'd want to know, you know, whether he thinks I should be referred to see a specialist about it. Many people have no idea there's anything wrong with their liver, even though it can be quite severely damaged. And often the first time they realise there's something wrong with their liver is when they see their doctor about something else, or just for a general checkup. One of the first questions I'll ask is how much you drink, and how long you've been drinking that amount for, and what the pattern of your drinking is. Your liver is the central organ involved in getting rid of that alcohol. As far as your liver is concerned, it's a poison, just like many poisons that your liver faces every day, and so it has to metabolise the alcohol to make it safe so that you don't continue harming your body. One of the first things that happens to your liver if you're drinking too much is you start to deposit a lot of fat in your liver. Thereafter, the liver doesn't like having all that fat in it, and it doesn't like the actual toxic effect of the alcohol, but it can become inflamed. And just as if you get, you know, inflammation if you've burnt yourself or something like that, your body repairs itself, you get scar tissue, and the same sort of thing happens in your liver. And so with repeated cycles of damage and repair and damage and repair, and that can accumulate so much so that you end up with this condition of cirrhosis, which is one of the later stages of alcoholic liver disease. There are different degrees of cirrhosis, and often we pick it up early, and say particularly in people who had no idea they were ill. And if they stop drinking, they've got a very good prognosis. They've got a good chance of survival. Of course, a lot of people do stop drinking, and you know, it takes a while for their health to improve. And there are other things they can do to improve their health further. If they're towards the sort of the later stage of the disease, they've already got a cirrhosis, then you know, eating a good, you know, well-balanced nutritional diet is important. I recently ran the London Marathon actually for the British Liver Trust, and I've been involved with the British Liver Trust over the last year or so, trying to raise awareness of liver disease generally. It's something that I think the public don't really know much about at the moment. It's a major disease in this country. It's increasing in its frequency. If you can stop drinking, then your liver has a very, very good chance of recovery. If you haven't got to the point where you've developed cirrhosis, then stopping drinking can completely reverse your liver disease, and it should go back completely to normal. And so your, you know, chance of living out a healthy life, you know, are as good as anybody's. If you have developed cirrhosis, so that's, you know, it is a problem, and it's something that we need to know about. And as doctors, we need to, you know, keep an eye on you. But again, if you can stop drinking, you'll reverse some of the damage that you've done, and you'll certainly stop your liver from getting worse. Many people, you know, who have got cirrhosis through drinking, but then who stop, can again live, you know, totally normally healthy lives.